This bone is a coxal bone. It's one of the three bones that make up your pelvis. Now this bone has three different regions to the one bone. We have the ilium region, where watch out for the spelling, it's I-L-I-U-M. If you put an E in there, that makes it intestines, so I-L-I-U-M. Then you have the ischium region, which is down here, and this part up here is going to be the pubis region. Ilium is superior, pubis is anterior, ischium is posterior. Now if we start with the ilium region, this ridge of bone right up top, this is going to be your iliac crest. Now a lot of times when people can feel a bone on their hip, they say that's your hip bone. What you're actually feeling is part of your iliac crest. This shallow indent right here, this shallow indent is going to be the iliac fossa, which then moves us to this ridge right here, going from the roughness you see on the outside here, down into here, to the pubis. This ridge is called the arcuate line. With this very large indent being the greater sciatic notch. The greater sciatic notch. Then we have the anterior superior iliac spine. A lot of words, but they tell you exactly what you're looking for. They say anterior, go to the front. Superior, come to the top. Iliac, be in the ilium region. Spine, point. Anterior, superior, iliac, spine. Then we have the anterior, inferior, iliac, spine. Anterior, inferior, iliac, spine. And then you have the posterior, superior, iliac, spine. Posterior, inferior, iliac, spine. So the names are telling you exactly where to look. Now moving to the anterior side over here, we can see the pubis region. The pubis region is going to have a junction right here where the two coxal bones join. This will form the pubic symphysis. So it's right where the two coxal bones will join is the pubic symphysis. This bump coming off here is going to be the pubic tubercle. Now when you put two of these bones together, you end up getting an entire pelvis. Now in this pelvis, you can see this is the pubic symphysis. These are the pubic tubercles. But then we also have a pubic arch, which is this area right down here, the pubic arch. While the pubic crest is just this area on top. But the larger area, so we stand up like this, and we're looking down into the pelvis. This whole opening going around here, the edges, is known as the pelvic brim. And now if you're looking from the top down, you can see the iliac crest here, across the iliac crest here. This whole open space between the two iliac crests is known as the greater or false pelvis. But if you look down inside, you can see this ischial spine to this ischial spine. That space between the ischial spines is known as the lesser pelvis or the true pelvis. Switching back to the individual coxal bone, you're going to have the acetabulum. Now, this entire opening is the acetabulum. The acetabulum is going to form your hip joint. It's where the femur will articulate, the head of the femur. It's the acetabulum. And then we only have one opening or one hole down here. This hole is known as the obturator foramen. Obturator foramen. So how do we know if this is a right or a left coxal bone? Well, we can look at it and say, okay, we know the pubis is anterior, ilium is superior, and acetabulum better be lateral, because our hip joint, our pelvic joint is out lateral. So we can say that this is going to be a right pelvic bone, or a right coxal bone. But there's also another way that's a little more non-traditional. You can think of almost answering the phone. Think of how you'd hold a phone. If you put your thumb and first finger through the greater sag notch, if your fingers cover the acetabulum, you have your phone like this, you put it to your head, that's where you're talking to the receiver. If it fits, it's a right. If you try on the left side, for instance, it doesn't fit. You can't get your fingers around the acetabulum. So if that works great, if not, go to a normal anatomical way. But it's one of those things that always looks funny, having someone with a coxal bone up to their ear trying to answer the phone, but it works. So whatever works for you, go for it. This one is a right coxal bone.